Really what happens when you think about our fat cells when it comes to dry fasting, because when you're dry fasting, and the body needs to create more water, okay? And fat cells have a lot of different hydrogen bonds, and then of course the oxygen that we breathe can create more water in our system. Our body can actually create water when we're not taking it internally. And that's why dry fasting can break down our fat cells faster than somebody who typically goes and does a water fast. Hi, I'm Dr. LeGrand, and I am a family doctor out here in the state of Washington, where I primarily focus on holistic medicine and conventional medicine, bringing those together to help my patients with their conditions. So if this is your first time on our channel, consider subscribing if you want more information on health tips, on fasting, intermittent fasting, and other detoxification videos. Hey, what's up, my fasters? It is Fasting Thursday. So today we're going to talk about dry fasting, the science behind dry fasting. So here we go. Let's get started. So first off, when it comes to dry fasting, is it a concern that our body goes in dehydration? Well, not really, not necessarily, at least at the start off. Our body actually produces what we call is an antidiuretic hormone, or also known as ADH. This gets pushed in our bloodstream through up to our kidneys to be able to help regulate our water depletion. So it helps absorb the water that we need to utilize, because when we're not consuming any water or any foods to kind of hydrate our body, the body will use ADH to be able to help absorb the water that we need. So that way our blood circulation is still has enough liquid going through it, as well as our organs that utilize it, such as the brain and all our other vital organs that need water. So our body's smart enough to know that it kind of produced that hormone to be able to continue utilizing that water. And you'll probably find, even when you do a dry fast, you'll probably not pee as much. In fact, your pee is gonna be a lot more diluted, and that's normal when you're doing a dry fast because of the ADH being increased, to be able to help with also making sure that we're regulating or utilizing our water in our body. Now, before I go any further, when it comes to dry fasting, this is really for experienced fasters, people who have done such as like juice fasting, cleansing, and specifically more doing water fasting, intermittent fasting. This isn't somebody who's a beginner, has never done fasting before, to jump into doing this. It is best to start with doing some juice fasting or water fasting before jumping into doing dry fasting. So getting that out of the way, let's move into why, all really particularly what happens with our fat cells in our body when we go through a dry fast. Really what happens when you think about our fat cells when it comes to dry fasting, because when you're dry fasting, and the body needs to create more water, okay? And fat cells have a lot of different hydrogen bonds, and then of course the oxygen that we breathe can create more water in our system. Our body can actually create water when we're not taking it internally. And that's why dry fasting can break down our fat cells faster than somebody who typically goes and does a water fast. So that's kind of the science behind that. But even more so, let's dive into really with the fat cells, how much does our fat cells have as far as water, what percentage of water? So the percentage of water in a healthy adult, or in just an adult general, with a fat-free mass, usually the percent of water is going to be about 70-75%. Now, adipose tissue, a lot of other fat cells, will roughly have about 10-40% of water. So there's definitely a lot of water that the body can utilize there to metabolize. But the other interesting thing is also looking at the science when it comes to fat cells and carbs, how our body metabolizes that for utilizing water. With this, when you look about 100 grams of fats, will usually equal to about 110 grams of metabolic water. Whereas about 100 grams of carbs will typically be something like about 55 grams of metabolic water. So the best source of water to metabolize when we're not drinking water is going to be fat. So people who are on the keto diet, or typically eating a higher fat diet and low carbs, are going to benefit more with dry fasting, because they're going to be able to utilize more of the fat cells to be able to use as water, but not only, also be losing the weight as well. So somebody who does a high carb diet and tries to experience doing a dry fast is going to have a hard time with it. But what also is interesting is looking at Ramadan. Now, a lot of the science out there for dry fasting is very scarce, But there's a lot of studies with Ramadan where a religion, the Muslims, actually experience doing dry fasting for a whole month once a day, where they're only eating during the night hours and fasting throughout the day, not eating any food or water. So they've been able to do some of these studies on here. And what's interesting to find is that they did a study on particularly a group of women doing Ramadan. And what they found is that oxidization for fat cells was increased versus carbs oxidization was decreased. So that's just really kind of to understand that the metabolism of fats work better during a dry fast versus carbs during a dry fast. And I know there's a lot of studies out there, even during Ramadan, where there'll be even increased amounts of calorie intake, or about roughly the same versus if they were not. And there's even a higher increase of carb intake. So if you really want to get the benefits of doing Ramadan or doing dry fast in general, trying to stick with more healthy fats, high fats, and decreasing on your carbs and sugars. So that's if you really want to get those benefits coming with dry fasting, you got to keep that in mind. Now, the other thing they kind of have to keep in mind is too, is with this study, is they found with dry fasting, decreases of insulin levels were shown. And that's also a very benefit when it comes to weight loss. Of decreasing the insulin levels can really help with us. So if you really are interested in finding out more about how to use dry fasting to lose weight, well, I will discuss that more in my next video. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel, go ahead and subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell. If you liked this video, give us a big thumbs up, share with your family and friends. And then of course, I will leave some links here. If you are first time here and haven't seen some of our videos, are coming back, then go ahead and check those out. And then of course, hit this notification bell over here to subscribe if you have not subscribed to our channel yet. Okay, that's it for today, guys. Love you guys, and I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye.